Good morning to all. So today we discuss the preparation of alcohols. So in the previous class we discussed about the meaning of the alcohol, and also we have completed the classification of alcohols. So based on the number of OH groups and also based on the hybridization we have discussed here. So today we discuss the preparation of alcohols. As you know that the alcohols can be prepared by many methods. So we can prepare alcohols by alkenes and also by the carbonyl compounds. So from alkenes we can prepare by the acid catalyzed reaction method, or we can prepare the hydroboration oxidation method. So first we see that is from alkenes. So preparation of, under the heading preparation of alcohols, in that we prepare from alkenes. So generally you know alkene means it should contain the carbon-carbon double bond. See, from alkenes, in that we have the acid catalyzed method, and also we can prepare by the hydroboration oxidation method. So first we see that is acid catalyzed reaction. So we can prepare alcohols by acid catalyzed reaction. That means here the acid acts as the catalyst. So from that we can prepare the alcohol. See here, I am taking alkene, general alkene, that is RCH double bond CH2. R, we can prepare R, it is a hydrogen, maybe it is any alkyl group, CH3 or C2H5, ethyl propyl butyl group. So here RCH double bond CH2 means it is alkene. So when this alkene is treated with the water, acid catalyzed hydrolysis. So here water, addition of water along with what here? Acid. So concentrated sulfuric acid I am taking here. So in the acid catalyzed hydrolysis, when the alkene is treated with water in presence of the acid, that is sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. So what happens here? So here the reaction takes place according to Markovnikov's rule. So here H2O is there. So in that H plus OH minus ions are there. See, H2O. So according to Markovnikov's rule, H plus ion should attach with the carbon containing more maximum number of hydrogen atoms. So this H plus ion attacks the CH3, then OH attaches to the carbon containing double bond with minimum number of the hydrogen atoms. So here what happens? There is a formation of R. I am writing here RCH. So I am writing this OH here, OH, then CH2 is there, add one hydrogen, what happens? It is CH3. So this is the compound, this is the final compound, that is alcohol. It is an alcohol. So what happened here? When generally we have taken the alkene in presence of acid with hydrolysis, addition of water, so there is preparation of an alcohol here. So now I am taking an example. If I replace R by hydrogen, what happens here? H, add this H to here, what happens? CH2, double bond CH2. So plus then addition of water along with the concentrated sulfuric acid. So what is the reaction? So here RCH double bond CH2. So alkene that reacts with the concentrated sulfuric acid. So in presence of the water, that means hydrolysis takes place. Finally we are getting the alcohol. See, for example, if I replace R by H, so here what happens? CH2 double bond CH2. So generally alkene means here carbon number, there are two carbon atoms are there, therefore I am writing here it is ethene. So there are two carbon atoms with double bond, therefore it is ethene. plus H2O plus what here? H2O. So then in presence of acid, that is sulfuric acid, then what is the product here? Just replace R by H. Replace R by H, what happens? So CH3CH with one hydrogen, what happens? CH3CH2 then OH. I am writing CH3CH2OH is a primary alcohol is formed. So there is formation of what here? It is primary alcohol. When the alkene is treated with the acid in presence of water, that means hydrolysis. So finally we are getting the alcohol. So this is the reaction. So let us know what is the mechanism of this reaction. So they may ask for your examination. So mechanism of acid catalyzed reaction or acid catalyzed hydrolysis. See here, this mechanism consists of three steps. It involves in three steps. So there are three steps here. So let us see what is the first step. So in the reaction we have seen, it contains the acid and the water. So from these two compounds there is a formation of the electrophile takes place. Electrophile. See here, we have taken H2O plus concentrated H2SO4 sulfuric acid, H2SO4. So they give up what here? There is a formation of H3O. So this water gains a proton forming H3O plus ion. This is electrophile. So electron deficient species. So electrophile plus what here? HSO4 minus. So this hydronium ion is an electrophile. So in the first step, this hydronium ion is very important. So this hydronium ion attacks on the ethene molecule, that is alkene generally. So hydronium ion, I am writing hydronium ion here. So this is with positive charge. So here it is alkene, ethene is there. So here what happens? This oxygen, this hydronium ion is unstable here. And the reactive part in alkene is this double bond, pi bond is very reactive. So what happens? This reacts with the hydrogen by gaining the proton. So it forms the CH3CH2 plus ion, that is carbocation is formed. Then remaining this H2O, remaining only H2O. So this electron migrates here. So this becomes H plus. This attaches with the one of the with carbon, so forming CH3. So here what happens? This electron comes here forming H2O water. I am writing. See, CH3 by gaining one of the hydrogen, it becomes CH3, then CH2 with positive charge. So this double bond shifts here, means the electron reacts with this hydrogen by gaining the hydrogen. So what happens? There is no double bond at all. So finally we get the H2O water molecule, H2O. So this is in the first step. So there is only just a formation of the carbocation. So from ethene, when ethene reacts with the hydronium ion, there is formation of carbocation. So this is carbocation, carbon containing the positive charge, that is carbocation. So in the second step, what happens? In the next step, that carbocation, I am writing CH3CH2 plus. See, in the reaction we have seen, the nucleophile is the water. The nucleophile is the water. See here, I am writing nucleophile water because it contains the lone pair of electron. The nucleophile. So this nucleophile, electrons will attack on this carbocation. So this is the carbocation as we have seen in the first step. So that in which, so what happens here, that nucleophile, it is electron rich, so that reacts with the carbocation. Then there is a formation of what? There is a formation of protonated alcohol. There is, I am writing here CS3, then CH2. Next, what here? So H2O is there. I am writing oxygen with two hydrogen atoms with containing the positive charge. Because the valency of the oxygen is 2, but I have written here 3 bonds with the oxygen, so it is getting positive charge. That means it is a protonated alcohol. See, in the first step what we have written, so water that reacts with the sulfuric acid is a catalyst. So there is formation of an ion, that is H3O plus ion. So this ion is called as the hydronium ion. So this hydronium ion acts as the electrophile, and that is HSO4 minus ion. So when this hydronium ion H3O plus ion, so this reacts with the alkene, so getting the carbocation in the first step. So that carbocation, it is there. So CH3 CH2 plus is there. So here the nucleophile is H2O. That water molecule attacks on this, so forming the protonated alcohol. So this is about the second step of the reaction mechanism. So the last step, here the protonated, here we want the alcohol. But what is the extra here? Here the extra atom is the hydrogen. One of the hydrogen is extra. So if you remove this hydrogen, what happens? There is a formation of alcohol. CH3CH2OH. So now in the last step, so elimination or loss of proton to give the what here? That alcohol. You can prepare the alcohol. So I am writing the last step. So step 3, what happens? Loss of proton. Finally we are getting what here? Loss of proton, finally alcohol. So CH3 CH2 OH with positive charge. So this reacts with the H2O water. That means it can gain a proton, forming the H3O plus ion again. So we are getting CH3 CH2 OH is alcohol plus H3O plus. That means hydronium ion is involved in the reaction. So it acts as a catalyst. So first it is involved in the reaction, then it will come back to the. So again, what happens? Only the product is, or getting the product as the ethyl alcohol. So this is the ethyl alcohol, or we can call it as a ethanol. It is a ethanol, the final product. So what we have done, only it contains the 3 steps. In the first step, there is generation of the electrophile takes place, that is H3O plus ion, that is hydronium ion. So that hydronium ion reacts with the alkene, that is ethene, in the second step, forming the carbocation. So in the third step, that protonated alcohol, so that protonated alcohol, what happens? That reacts with the H2O. So finally we are getting the loss of proton to form the alcohol. So this is the mechanism of the reaction, that is acid catalyzed reaction or acid catalyzed hydrolysis. See, from alkene, so in that we can prepare alcohol even by the hydroboration oxidation method. So the second method of preparation from alkene is the by hydroboration oxidation. With hydroboration oxidation also we can prepare alcohol. Hydroboration means addition of the, that is borane, diborane we are taking here. So oxidation means the addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen. So this here we are adding the oxygen, so that is the hydrogen peroxide we are adding. So here we can call it as a by hydroboration oxidation method. See here, I am writing CH3, CH double bond CH2. So I am taking here 2 moles of propene, 2 moles of propene. So that reacts with diborane. So BH3 I am taking, BH3 twice. That means we have the formula for diborane, that is B2H6. It is a formula for diborane. So diborane can also be written as BH3 taken twice. That means B into 2, here B2. So H3, 3 to the 6. So I am writing here. Why I am writing, that we'll come to know next year. See, so this reacts with propene reacts with this diborane forming, see here, CH3CH, very reactive part is the double bond, so this is the reactive part. Here the addition takes place according to the anti-Markovnikov's rule, according to anti-Markovnikov's rule, as we have studied in the first year class. So here BH3 is there, one of the hydrogen attaches to the, not this carbon atom, it is Markovnikov's rule, but it is according to anti-Markovnikov's rule. What happens, this hydrogen atom attaches to the this carbon containing least number of hydrogen atoms, so forming, I am writing here CH3CH2, single bond CH2BH2. See here, CH3, I have written CH3, CH is there, one of the hydrogen from BH2, BH3, so BH2, that is CH2, then again CH2. So if you remove one hydrogen, there is only two hydrogen, that means BH2 is there, so BH2. So 2 I have written here, 2, that is number of moles equal to 2. Here is also, so here also 2. This is diborane. So this is the first step we see. So next, what happens? This addition product, intermediate product, so I am writing here CH3 CH2 CH2 BH2, plus again propene, again if this reacts with the propene, that is CH3 CH double bond CH2. See here, I have written the addition product, as we have seen in the last case, that the product I have written here, the intermediate, yeah, I have written with again propene, I am taking propene here. So what happens next? Next, there is a formation of, see here, CH3CH2CH2 is there, it is also CH3CH2 is there, so I am writing CH3CH2CH2. So one of the hydrogen attaches here again, similar manner as we have seen in the last case. So this part is double. This part is double, it becomes double. I am writing here CH3 CH2 CH2, I am writing BH, not BH2, not BH2. Why means, again here addition, it attaches with the this carbon. So I can take it as a twice, it is a twice, two times, because so this is one part and this one is one part, I have written directly two times. So it is not the final product, it is not the final product till we don't have any alcohol. So next step, so when this addition product CH3 CH2 CH2 two times BH, again propene, that is CH3CH double bond CH2. See, very simple concept is there, don't confuse yourself. See, this again reacts with the propane, again addition takes place. So how, what happens here, according to anti-Markovnikov's rule, this hydrogen attached to the carbon containing the least hydrogen, so forming, see here two times is there, again add one more time, what happens, it is 3. So I am writing CH3 CH2 CH2 CH2, then B, not BH, then B. Why it is B? So one of the hydrogen attaches here, pretty simple. So there is formation of CH3, CH2, CH2 thrice B. It is a, again, intermediate we have got. So it is not a final product. So again, in the last step, what happens? CH3, CH2, 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 B, thrice. So this reacts with the oxidation. So this is hydroboration. Up to this, it is a hydroboration. Then we have oxidation, that is 3 moles of hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. There is addition of hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. So here what happens, this oxygen combines with this carbon atom. So what happens, there is formation of CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. So hydrogen is there, oxygen is there. Then there is a formation of byproduct S3BO3. Boric acid is formed, S3BO3. See here, total number of hydrogen is 3 to the 6, oxygen 3 to the 6 here, 3 to the 6. So here I am writing 3, then it become 3 oxygen, here also 3 oxygen. So hydrogen is also balanced, number of boron is only 1 here, here also 1. So hydrogen, how it is? 3 hydrogen. So here also 3 hydrogen, totally 6 hydrogen. So this is called as the hydroboration oxidation method. So from this method we can prepare the alcohol. So lastly we got, that is propyl alcohol, or it is propanol we got. So see here once again. So what have you taken? The reactant. Reactant is the propene. So with the double bond is there, therefore it is propene. When this propene reacts with the diborane, so diborane I have written here like this, BS3 twice, not B2H6. So actually the formula for diborane is the B2H6 is there, but we have written BS3 twice. So what happens, this BS3, from this BS3, so this addition takes place according to anti-Markovnikov's rule. Anti-Markovnikov's rule, that means hydrogen attaches here, carbon, double bonded carbon containing the least number of hydrogen atom. So least number means here hydrogen is 1, here hydrogen is 2. So the hydrogen attaches the center carbon. So I have written here the center carbon containing 2 hydrogen atoms. So remaining BH2 that attaches with the last carbon atom. So this is the first reaction. Next we have, so this addition product reacts with the again the reactant, that is propene. Again propene. So this group is 2, twice. Again addition takes place according to anti-Markovnikov's rule. So this part is double, I have written twice, 1 hydrogen is less. Then again it repeats. So this group is 3, so already 2 is there plus 1, so it becomes 3 thrice I have written. So along with B, so then this intermediate part reacts with the hydrogen peroxide. That means it is the oxidation method. Oxidation, undergoes oxidation, means addition of oxygen takes place. So finally we got the propyl alcohol with boric acid as the byproduct. So this is the preparation of alcohol from alkenes, in that particularly by that is hydroboration oxidation method. So we have seen two methods of preparation from alkene, that is first one is the by acid catalyzed hydrolysis, and second one is the, that is hydroboration oxidation method. So alcohols we can also prepare by the carbonyl compounds. Generally we can prepare the alcohols by the carbonyl compounds. So in that particularly we are using aldehydes and ketones. So here the aldehyde containing the general formula RCHO, and the ketone containing the RCOR-. So carbonyl group is there, CO group is there. Therefore, we call it as our carbonyl compounds. So we can prepare alcohols by using the carbonyl compounds, in that particularly, that is aldehydes and ketones. And also, we can prepare alcohols by using the carboxylic acid. That is the general formula for carboxylic acid is RCOOH. We can also prepare the alcohol. and even we can use esters. The general formula for the ester is RCOO R dash, that is by the reduction of the ester we can prepare the alcohols. Even we can prepare the alcohols by the Grignard reagent. So all these remaining preparations we can see in the next class. Thank you.